I guess you could say, in summary, what I actually offer to people is practical solutions that keep their feet on the ground while they're reaching for the stars in whatever place that they want to go or whatever it is that they want to do in their life. I'm a firm believer in helping people to give themselves permission to shine. I guess what I'm particularly known for is helping people identify the barriers. What's actually blocking them? What's in the way of getting to where they want to go or having what they want? Once we identify those, I am able to help them break through those barriers to remove them in a way that suits their lifestyle and their personality, and then determine what skills they need or what's needed to be developed to get the outcomes that they want in their life. I have a knack for quickly identifying and unblocking what's in the way of people achieving their goals, whether they be business goals or personal goals. And my style is pretty much tell it like it is, get right to the point, and speak that truth. And people actually like that about me. I actually work with people who are in transition. This could be people or a group of people, if it's a company or a particular organization, that are wanting a total makeover, a total culture change in their department or in their company. Or it could be somebody that just wants one aspect of their life changing. When I talk about working in transition, you know, in life we go through various phases of transition. It might be that I'm single and now I'm going to be married. So I'm going to go through a transition of being a single person to a married person. It might be that I'm going to be a parent. It might be that my children are leaving the nest. It might be within my career that I want to change careers. At the core of every transition is the identity. So it involves an identity change, an identity evolving. And I work with the nature of identity with people, authentic self-expression, and the transition in that expression into any area of their life, personally or professionally. When people want to have a good sexual relationship, what I find is that they actually want connection. And it's through the connection of the heart and the mind and the ideas and our bodies and knowing how to ask for what we want and not feel ashamed and to receive that, that makes a huge difference. People have to be guided on how to do that. You can all understand what I'm saying. But actually, can I really do it when I get in the bedroom and I have my clothes off? It's a whole different kettle of fish. So sexuality is natural for us, but very unnatural when we have so many things in the way to actually having it. Sexuality is such a misunderstood topic, particularly in the expression of our sexuality in couples, whether they be heterosexual or homosexual, it doesn't really matter. And in that expression, people often want to band-aid symptoms of what's not happening right or how they can't perform or they're anxious or they're inhibited. And actually, they talk about the most important sex organ that we have is between our two ears. That's been a joke that people have said. It's very important to address what's underlying that's blocking that sexuality. In most couples, I find it's years of resentment that have been put on layer upon layer upon layer, a little bit at a time. It's the shame of self-expression or body image issues. It's not knowing how to let go and enjoy yourself or receive pleasure that you deserve it. So when we unblock those underlying issues, and perhaps people can learn some skills to enhance their sexuality as well. But those combined together actually get to the core area of having a sexual relationship that's loving and fantastic and connected and close. So when we can get to the underlying condition that prevents us from having that and clear that away, it's as natural as breathing. It's fun. It's healthy for us. So having a fulfilling, fun, exciting, loving, close sexual relationship is our birthright. And you can have it. We have a clinic in Neutral Bay, New South Wales, in Sydney, Australia. I also do sessions via the internet on Skype and telephone sessions with people individually, custom designing keynotes for many organizations. And the keynotes tend to have an inspirational message to them. They could be anything from helping people rediscover and reconnect with their mojo to going on the hero's journey, to overcoming obstacles to success, to overcoming the fear of success. So many different topics, but they tend to have that inspirational message to them of fearing forward to a challenge and actually winning and getting the results that you want. I've been involved in spirituality and the discovery of that and the development of that for many, many years, before it was even popular. It's now quite popular. And what I have begun to reduce it down to and bring into my work are spiritual principles. What I mean by that are principles of faith, hope, trust, surrender, letting go, how to let go, be more spontaneous, principles of love, power, issues around power, enthusiasm, you know, this spirit of us, the passion of us, learning how to live with grace in a letting go and receiving and deserving something, having the right divine timing to something when you're creating and you're goal setting. So spiritual principles to me are human principles. It's been said we're spiritual beings in a human body, or we're spiritual beings having a human experience on earth. And I find that those principles are very much human. We have, it's like I would say the context of our work is held in spiritual principles, which to me are necessary if you really want to have any type of lasting change.